Oh, it's hot. Welcome to the island of Nauru. This little island nation, one of the smallest countries in the world, is situated right in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. So to fly here, it's 4 hours from Australia. The closest other nation is like Marshall Islands and Kiribati, which is 2 hours that way, 2 hours that way flying. So it's in the middle of nowhere. Really difficult to get here. That's why it's one of the least visited countries in the world, with approximately 200 visitors a year. I doubt it's that much, to be honest. Nauru is, of course, really interesting because it's such a small, isolated nation of its own. It's so small, you can actually walk around the whole country in one day. But it's also a bit of a sad story, a bit of a paradise lost, because but 90% of this island has been destroyed because of phosphate mining. The colonial powers, Germany, Great Britain, some Australian companies were taking part of this mining in the early 1900s. But then as the country gained independence in the 60s, the local authorities just continued and expanded this mining industry. So 90% of the island is destroyed. And it's just like a moon-like apocalyptic World War I environment, which is impossible to do anything with. So tag along in this little video to see how Nauru looks like. So, how do you destroy a tropical paradise island? You bring in a couple of hundreds of these, dig up for phosphates. When you've dug up the whole island, then you put the phosphate in machines like these and make it all into soil and ship it to the rest of the world. And left is a dry island with no life. Really sad. Walking inland in Nauru, bit of a tragic sight. Dumped trash. But worst of all, the whole landscape, the whole island has been dug up during years, decades, hundreds of years of mining for phosphates. So it's dry, inhabitable, and an ecological disaster for the whole country. So, Paradise Island, the hike up to the former Japanese defense bastion is covered with litter, plastic, and like old cars, and smells like ugh.